two.
Hi, my name is Rick Sanchez. I'm with a company called Tractor Tip Equipment, and what we have for sale here today is a Volvo. This is an EC330. This is a 30 metric ton machine. CL means that it's a long carriage machine, or rather C is the series, and then L means it's a long carriage. I'll talk a little bit about that later. The serial number of this machine is, it's a long one, so I'm just gonna give you the last part of it. It's 11003. I'm gonna leave that last digit blank. If you buy this excavator from me or some of the other machines that I have for sale, you see we've got a box blade there, we got some backhoes, we got some loaders, we got some big water tankers, 5,000 gallon water tankers, we got some big excavators. I've got a total of 4 big excavators right now. Point is that if you buy any of these tractors from me, you're gonna be dealing with Pro Provencio. He's the guy running the camera right now. Price on a new machine like this these days, price on a new machine these days is anywhere from $400,000 to $450,000, depending on how you get it equipped. The hours on this machine are about 5,500. As far as manufacturers go, Volvo is pretty ubiquitous out there. They're one of the top manufacturers for heavy construction mining equipment in the United States and around the world. This particular machine weighs 79,530 pounds. The widest point are those tracks right there at 11'3". Highest point is the top of that cab when it's in transport profile. It's 12'3". And the transportation length when everything's tucked in and transport profile is 36 foot from the end of that counterweight to the front of this knuckle right here. Comparable machines are like a Komatsu PC360, like those machines there. That KCX350 is pretty close to it too. These machines are just a little bit heavier, but not by much. As far as the history of this unit goes, this machine, like almost every machine we purchase, comes from one of about 30 different large contractors and municipalities that we deal with here in the Metroplex. This particular machine came from a company that we do quite literally millions of dollars of business with. And they're one of the largest contractors in Texas, probably in the United States for that matter. But point is, we do a lot of business with these guys, and we buy from them and we sold to them. But we've been happy with all the machines that we bought from them. They have an excellent maintenance program that rivals some of the best I've ever seen. We've been happy with all the machines that we bought from them. It should be said that before I purchase any machine, I have 2 mechanics that go out and inspect it, and if they say everything's okay with the machine, then I send Pro Provencio to go out and inspect it, and he knows what he's looking at. And if he says everything's okay with the machine, and if the money's right, then I personally go out and I inspect it. So these machines are 3 and 4 times vetted before we even consider buying them. As far as options go, you can see this machine is an enclosed cab. The AC in it blows cool, but not real cold. This machine is it's got auxiliary hydraulics here. Now these are dual function auxiliary hydraulics, so you can run a breaker, you can run a shear, you can run just about anything on this machine. We'll talk about the engine here in a little bit. I gotta jump up there. All the fluid levels on this machine are where they should be. Everything on it works. Top speed on this machine is about 3 miles an hour. The undercarriage, as you can see, is probably about 85%. There's no leaks or any kind of problems on the final drives. The final drives have got plenty of power to counter rotate. All of the, everything on this machine works. I can't think of anything that doesn't work. Can you, Chrome?
No, even the lights.
The lights work, everything works. The hydraulics are strong. There's no cracks or welds anywhere in this work equipment here. All of the pins and the bushings are relatively tight. There's no deflection or any kind of problem in this turntable or this articulation gear, in the Rotex. As far as this bucket goes, this is a 36 inch bucket. Okay, it's got a 39 inch bite. The height of this bucket is 5'6". The depth of it is 6'3". I would rate it about 1.75 yards. The maximum dig depth on this machine is 22 feet. The maximum reach at ground level is 34 feet. Maximum dig height is 34 feet. The breakout force on this machine is 50,000 pounds. The maximum lifting capacity, there's actually a chart in here on that. The maximum lifting capacity this machine's got a maximum lifting capacity of about 42,000 pounds in the position that it is right now. Now obviously the further out you go, the higher up you go, you know, your lifting capacity is going to change. Also if you're lifting from the front or lifting from the side, but to get into all those measurements, I'll just take a picture of the chart. These tracks here, these tracks, the standard track on a Volvo EC330 is 32 inches. These are 36 inches. So what does that mean? That means that you got more stability, you got greater lifting force, you got a lower PSI rating. The PSI rating on this machine is probably like 5 or 6 as opposed to 7 to 8. On a regular track, the drawbar pull on this machine is 58,000 pounds. That drawbar pull is the amount of weight a machine can push or pull in addition to its own. This one's 58,000. I think that's about it. What else, bro?
You got it covered. It's a good machine.
It's a good machine. Everything works. We got others to choose from, so we'll give you a volume discount if you buy more than one. So this is the inside of the cab here.
These are your hours. I can't read them from my angle. 5582.
Here's your air conditioner controls. AC blows, but not cold. So that probably needs to be recharged. Here's your radio controls. I'm not sure what that's for. These are your work lamps. These are your pedals for your auxiliary hydraulics right here. These are your joystick controls. I mean your travel levers. And there's your seat. You have a little bit of a tear right there, but it's nothing too major.